Let's look at what factors affect the margin of error in confidence intervals for the population mean mu. Suppose we use this confidence interval formula to construct a confidence interval for the population mean mu. This would be the appropriate method if we were sampling from a normally distributed population where the population standard deviation sigma is known. And this bit here is the margin of error of the confidence interval. And this video looks at the various factors that affect that margin of error. The margin of error is determined by the standard deviation sigma, the sample size n, and the confidence level 1 minus alpha, because the confidence level is tied in with this z value. Let's do one quick margin of error calculation. If sigma is 10 and n is 64, what is the 95% margin of error? Well, here's our margin of error formula. And if you recall, the appropriate z value for a 95% margin of error is 1.96. And so our margin of error is going to be 1.96 times 10 over the square root of 64. And this works out to 2.45. Now let's look at what happens to the margin of error when we change sigma and n and the confidence level. Let's look at the effect of the standard deviation sigma on the margin of error. The greater the standard deviation, the greater the uncertainty, and the more difficult it is to pin down the value of the parameter of interest, and so the greater the margin of error. We can see here that sigma, the standard deviation, is in the numerator, and that the margin of error increases linearly with the standard deviation sigma. And so all other factors being equal, a doubling of the standard deviation would result in a doubling of the margin of error. Now let's look at the effect of the sample size on the margin of error. The greater the sample size, the more information we have, and the more precisely we're going to be able to pin down the value of the parameter of interest, and so the smaller the margin of error. We can see here that it is the square root of the sample size that's in the denominator. So if we wanted to cut our margin of error in half, we would need to quadruple our sample size. And so there are diminishing returns here. When we increase the sample size from 20 to 200, say, there is a dramatic reduction in the margin of error. But an increase in the sample size of 600 to 800 doesn't have nearly the same effect. What about the effect of the confidence level on the margin of error? The confidence level is tied in with this z value. And as we've learned previously, for a 95% confidence level, the appropriate z value is 1.960. For a 99% confidence level, the appropriate z value is 2.576. So if we want greater confidence, we're going to have to deal with a greater margin of error. Here I've plotted in the relationship between the margin of error and the confidence level, holding all other factors equal. At 95%, this was the 2.45 that we calculated earlier. But if we wanted a 99.99% margin of error, we would have to deal with a margin of error that is about double that. We can see that beyond 95, this curve goes up rather quickly. In most practical situations, we feel that the choice of a 95% confidence level provides a good balance between high confidence and a reasonable margin of error.